शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरु परम्पराम् श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्तृप्त्यर्थ निर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं मत्तोऽन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। सो इन दि लास्ट पार्ट सम 10 डेज बैक आई थिंक वी फिनिश दि थर्ड चैप्टर which was the Guru Shishya Lakshana, mostly Guru Lakshana. And in the earlier two chapters, we have seen the Anubandha Chatushtaya, briefly in the first chapter and in detail in the second chapter. Now this is the fourth chapter where teaching begins in detail for different types of adhikaris. So this particular chapter is meant for an Uttama Adhikari. Atha Uttama Adhikarinaha उपदेश निरूपण नाम चतुर्थ स्तरंग फोर्थ वेव द फोर्थ चैप्टर इन विचार सागर विच इज मेंट फॉर उत्तम अधिकारी हाउ हाउ इज द टीचिंग टुवर्ड्स एन उत्तम अधिकारी इज सीन हियर इन दिस चैप्टर थ्रू अ स्टोरी दिस इज कल्पिता स्टोरी कथा कल्पिता कथा एंड meant for an uttam adhikari. So chaturtha staranga idani guru shishya samvadatmika kachana purva akhyayika virachyate. So kachana apurva, unheard before because it is not there in any shruti smriti purana itihasa grantha. So this has been imagined by the author, the sadhu. Akhyayika virachyate, and how is it is in the form of guru shishya samvada. Like Gita is Arjuna and Krishna Arjuna is Samvada. Similarly, this is Guru Shishya Samvada. Most of the teachings in the Shruti also, Upanishads also, they are a dialectic. Thereby, the Akhyayika, which has been created by the Sadhu, that Akhyayika is also in the form of a dialogue between the Guru and the Shishya. एतत् श्रवण मात्रेण जिज्ञासुः मुमुक्षुः आत्मविचारे भृशं समर्थो भवेत्. एंड ही मेक्स अ क्लेम हियर दैट दिस स्टोरी बाय इट्सेल्फ, नो, जस्ट लिसनिंग टू दिस स्टोरी विल मेक अ पर्सन एन अधिकारी अधिकारी इन आत्मविचार. इफ अ पर्सन इज अ मुमुक्षु एंड अ जिज्ञासु मोक्ष इच्छु एज वेल एज जिज्ञासु ज्ञान ज्ञान इच्छु देन ही विल बिकम केपेबल इन आत्मविचार कंप्लीटली भृशम समर्थो भवति भवेत. सो दिस इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी शोन बाय दि साधु हियर. इवन इन उपनिषद्स देर आर मेनी पीपल हु लिसन टू उपनिषद्स बट देन थ्रू श्रवण देर इज नो ज्ञानोत्पत्ति. बट व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट दे बिकम अधिकारीज. Therefore, multiple times if Shravana takes place, then sometime the knowledge will stay, will take its effect on Ajnana, it will remove the Ajnana. So, 122nd to 155th, Shubha Santatehe Rajnyaha Tattva Drishtiriti, Adrishtiriti, Tarka Drishtiriti, Samakhyatanam Tatputranam Cha Katha. So, between 122nd and 125, these sections, there is a king who has three sons. The king is called as Subhasantati, and he has three sons, Tattvadrishti, Adrishti, and Tarkadrishti. These are names given based on the Adhikari, Adhikara Bheda, thereby Tattvadrishti, Adrishti, and Tarkadrishti. These are the three sons for the Raja. So the Katha is, Katha surrounds the life of the Raja and the Putras, how they want moksha, how all of them want moksha and how they get it. That is the story. So Shubhasantatehe Trailokyadipatyam. Shubhasantati, this king, was the Trailokya Adhipati. He was the ruler of all the three worlds. So that kind of an emperor he was, ruler of the three worlds. Shubhasantatir Nama Kaschana Raja Lokatrayam Anushasasa. So he was doing Anushasana of the three worlds. Some Raja, Shubhasantati. Tasyaha Asan Trayaha Putraha. So he had three sons, Tattvadrishti, Adrishti, and Tarkadrishti. These are the three. Iti cha Vikhyata. They were also famous. These, in the Vyakhyana, he is saying that this, see, obviously when the king is ruling over the three worlds, his family is famous. Chatushastra Pravinashcha. They are also trained in all the Shastras. Techa Kramena Asmin Granthe Chaturta Panchama Shastat Tarangeshu Uttama Madhyama Kanishthadikarikvena Varnyante. The book has five chapters. Three chapters have gone by. In the fourth, fifth and sixth chapters, the Chaturtha, Panchama and Shashta Taranga, in those Uttama in the Chaturtha, Madhyama in the Panchama and Kanishta in the Kanishta Adhikari in the Shashta. This is the arrangement, Shashta Adhyaya. This is the kind of arrangement in this text. And Adhikaritvane, Adhikari Bheda is there. Jnana Bheda isn't there. Jnana given through all methodologies is the same. And all Jnana will lead to Moksha, Aikya Jnana. Thereby, if we don't get it in the fourth, we should try the fifth and the sixth and continue. It will definitely lead to Jnana. And just because we feel, okay, I'm not getting it, we should not skip it. So that is the idea here. Raja tu Shubhasantati Saishavam Kridayam Yovanam Chastribhoge Viniyunjanopi Swabhujabalena Lokatrayavi Nyayena Margena Apalayat. So he, the Raja himself, Shubhasantati, in his long life, in his Shishu Avastha, he spent, I mean, just like us, just like most of us, of course, he had more means to his disposal. We may have limited means, but he being the king of all the three worlds, he had a lot of resources at his disposal. He spent his Krida, the Shishu Avastha in Krida, playing around. Yauvanam chastri bhoge, and he indulged in, you know, playing around with the opposite gender in his yauvana, in his young days. And even so, shaishavam kridayam yauvanam chastri bhoge viniyunjano api. Even if he spent his time, he was engaged in playful activities and sports till swabhuja balena lokatrayopi nyayena margena apalayat. Still Nyayena Margena, still he was led by Dharma. His indulgence was also led by Dharma because he won over the three worlds through his Swabhuja Bala, but Nyayena. Not only Swabhuja Bala, Ravana also has done that, Swabhuja Bala, but still won over the three worlds with Dharma, Nyayena. And not only won over, Margena Palayat. He also continued to rule over the Praja through Nyaya. Putreshu Rajyam Samarpya Shubhasantate Pravrajanam. Let me just close the window. There's a lot of rain here. I can barely hear my voice, so I have to yell. Okay. So, Putreshu Rajyam Samarpya Shubhasantate Pravrajanam. So, now he has reached the part where briefly is told what the Raja did. Now, Raja is going out. He is moving to Vanaprastha Ashrama, having given his Rajya, Trailokya, all the three lokas to his three sons. Tasya Rajya Kadachit Swapurva Punyavashat Atma Ajo Nityaha Niratishya Ananda Sarupascha Tato Anyat Sarvam Dukhatmakam Iti Viveka Udiyaya. So due to some punya, Rajya Kadachit, sometime Swapurva Punyavashat, there is some punya that he has earned across janmas, which is ripe for fructification now, which led to Vairagya. And then it led to Viveka. Viveka driven Vairagya. First Viveka. What Viveka? The Viveka is Nitya Nitya Vastu Viveka. The first qualification for a sadhaka. So Atma Ajaha. Ajaha. Na jataha iti ajaha. Na jayate. Jayate iti ja. So da pratyanta. Ditva ter lopa. So jandhatu becomes ja here with a. With a as in this is nanj. So nanj satpurusha ajaha. Unborn. Atma is never born. Okay, if it is not born, it is anadi. But is it antavat? Antavan? Is Atma antavan or not? There he says nityaha. Atma ajaha nitya api. So anadi and ananta. Niratishaya ananda swarupascha. And he knows that it is ananda swarupa. All this Saishava Krida and Yovanastri Bhoga, all this is Mithya. He says, I did not get any Sukha through this. I got Sukha only because of my Ananda Sarupa. Atma is Niratishaya Ananda Sarupa. So there was some pending Bhoga and Punya which had fructified in two ways. One is in the form of the Trailokya Rajyam. And the second one was his Viveka. After he enjoyed and had, you know, three sons who are also trained well. Finally, there is Viveka Utpatti, and then he knew that Atma Ajaha Nityaha Niratishaya Ananda Sarupascha, and anything other than that, Tato Anyat. Tato Anyat, Atmanaha Anyat, Sarvam Dukhatmakam. Because Atma being Ananda Sarupa, anything other than Atma does not have Sukha, and what does not have Sukha? If it takes you away from your Atma Swarupa, it will be Dukkhatmaka. It is Dukkha Rupa. Atma here is in the sense of form of, in the form of Dukkha. Everything is in the form of Dukkha except for Atma. Iti Viveka Udiyaya. Ut Iyaya. It rose. Ingatav Dhatu. Utpurvaka Ingatav Dhatu. So, Udiyaya, it arose. That kind of a Viveka came up in his Buddhi. Tadasa achintayata. Then he thought, what did he think? Aham atma vicharam kuryam. So let me do atma vichara. Let me stay with this atma. This viveka is there. Then why am I spending time with dukkhatmaka sarva? Trailokya. I should be spending time with atma. Aham atma vicharam kuryam. Trayav putra mama trailokyam palayantu. Let the three words which I have won over, let them be ruled over by three sons. Iti. Tato mantri dvara putran swasvamipam anayya swasya bhoge vairagyam ekante ratincha tebhyo nivedya rajyadikaram angikartum tan ajnapayan ekekasmai ekaikam lokam vibhajya adat. So vibhajya, having divided ekaikam lokam. Ekai kasmai. To each of his putra, he gave one loka to rule over. He says, you take care of this. So, with this idea, he called his mantri. Mantri dvara putran swasvamipamanaya. He called his three sons and then swasya bhoge vairagyam ekante ratincha tebhyo nivedya. Having told them about his vairagya, unto any bhoga. He is not interested in any bhoga anymore. Therefore, rajyadikaram angikartum. Please, you know, take care of this rajya, accept it, and then tan ajnapayan. How should you also continue to take care of this your praja, the way I have taken care of? Through nyaya. Nyayat anapetam nyayam. So that is Nyayam. Nyaya and Nyaya, there is a difference. Nyaya is a Taddhita. Nyaya, Nyayat Anapetam Nyayam. What is not divorced from Nyaya, what is in keeping with Nyaya is called as Nyayam, which was seen earlier. This Nyayam, Nyayena. So he asked them to continue. Nyayena, each of them should take care of one loka. Vibhajya rajyadani putranam mitakkalaha tanmulakataya prajanam dukkhancha bhaved iti manvanaha raja. Now he is thinking that if I had left it, if I leave the rajya to the putras themselves, then generally, there is a difference in the three lokas. Whatever difference is there, there may be kalaha, there may be a fight. Mitha, mutually they may fight with each other. I want this loka. General thinking is there, when parents divide something, not necessarily property also, whatever is there, it's limited. When you divide among your children, that time, even while serving food also, you take care that, each children gets a right quantity. So mitaha kalaha ma bhut, that is the thinking there. Let it not be there. Otherwise, what will happen if they fight over mutually? Then tanmula kataya, that will become the seed for prajanam dukkham cha bhaved. Then it will lead to praja dukkha also. So Raja is thinking, what is praja? If I go away without giving away my sampatti and handing over properly, then what will happen is they might fight amongst each other, and then that will lead to praja dukkha. Thinking so, manvanah raja, iti manvanah raja, who is thinking in this manner, swayam eva swarajyam putrebhyo vibhajyadat. Vibhajya adat, he himself gave this. It is not that, he left it to their own whims or, however you want it, you take care of it. He, while stepping out also, he saw to it that whatever is dukkhatmakam also, they are having some sukha. So let them continue with the sukha, the putras also and the praja also, whatever little sukha they have in loka, let them get that. Let that not be taken away from them by the kalaha between putras. Therefore, he also thought about his praja continuing the way they are continuing to be taken care of. Yatra manavo murtaha san parameshwara taraka mantra upadesham labdha anayasena muktin labheta yatra cha sarvantaryami visheshwara sadasannihitaha. So yatra manavaha murtaha san, when human beings die, having died, parameshwara taraka mantra upadesham labdha, there is a the shruti derived from shruti puranas mentioned, Bhagavatam mentions that in Kashi Kshetra, Kashi Maranam is very famous. People used to, in earlier era when there were no vehicles, people used to walk and go to Kashi from remote villages from all over India. The idea was to die in Kashi. Even if one went to Kashi, they would say that, a person may not come back because the journey was too long and tiresome across months and years, maybe, based on the capacity of the person, if the person is old, and based on where the person is starting from. And even today, there are some lodges where they are meant for that reason. If you feel that, if a person feels that I am going to die, that person goes and stays in a particular lodge. They give that arrangement so that the person can die in Kashi, because there is an idea that Kashi Marana leads to moksha. What kind of moksha is debatable, but we should take it that there is some kind of moksha possible. It can be any kind of moksha. There are various kinds of mokshas talked about, but it is better than this Swarga Loka Ityadi. Some moksha is possible. Some type of moksha may or may not be nitya. We are not debating that, because jnanotpatti is possible even at the last moment. Jnanena moksha is not to be compromised. Everything else is fine. Now this jnanena moksha also may be possible because parameshwara taraka mantra upadesham labdhva. This taraka mantra can lead to jnana. Aikya jnana may be possible if it is if the person is ready, he has had some, it is not exactly due to Taraka Mantra Upadesha, but Taraka Upadesha Mantra may take away obstacles. We have to do Samanvaya because it is said, here he says, we'll see further, it is Iti Shruti Ukta. So if it was a Shruti, and generally the idea is that as long as the Purana or any of these Smriti and Purana Granthas, they do not contradict with the Shruti, they are taken as Pramana because they are derivatives of Shruti. So we should not say Purana Katha may be discounted, but the if it says by this moksha, we should not directly jump on Arthavada. It can be Arthavada if it is contradictory to Shruti. If it is not contradictory to Shruti, we should do some Samanvaya. So one Samanvaya possible is because Parameshwara himself, Ishwara, Shiva himself gives the, he stays in cremation grounds, and Kashi cremation ground is such that there Shiva is continuously there. He uses the same bhasma. And the bodies are continuously burning on the ghat. So there, since people want moksha, they go there for that purpose. They have to get something out of it. So there, Parameshwara, Manava Mrutasan. When Manava Mrutasan means Manava is not this body. This is clear because it is Atma who has become, as though become Jiva. That Jiva has taken the Manava Sharira and become Manushya. And Mrutasan, having given up that body, Manushya Sharira, with the idea that I want to die in Kashi and get moksha, there when the body is being burned, when that person is taken there, Parameshwara Taraka Mantra Upadesham Labdva. He gets the Taraka Upadesha Mantra, and then that Jivatma, it is said that while dying, the Jiva is not completely separated yet from the body, and that time here, Kashyam hi Jantoho Praneshu Utkramaneshu Rudraha Shiva Rudra Tarakam Brahma Vyachaste Tarakam Brahma. So Taraka Mantra which will lead to Brahma Upadesha Aikyanyana Vyachaste Yena Aso Amruta Bhutva Mokshan Labate. So this setup is such that if one can reach there and get the Taraka Mantra, there is a possibility of moksha. Iti Shrutya Vipraya Atra Darshita. Shruti has an Abhipraya. It is not from elsewhere. It is a Shruti statement. Yatra kutrapi va kashya marane samayishraha jantor dakshina karane tu mattaram samupadishet. So, jantor dakshina karane tu mattaram samupadishet. So, the upadesha would be given in the dakshina karana, in the right ear, by Rudra. Marane sa Maheshwaraha mantra is given by Maheshwara himself. Iti Shruti Abhipraya Atra Darshita in saying that Anayasena Muktin Labhet. So there is no Ayasa in that. Ayasa is in reaching Kashi. But getting Mukti is easy. Okay, debatable, but then since it is a Shruti statement, we have to understand that there may be a possibility of obstacles going away if a person is ready and some obstacle is there that may go away. Because it is a Brahma Upadesha by Maheshwara himself. And at the point of time when, see, when a person dies accidentally or through a lot of roga with lot of kama there, then a person does not have the state of mind to listen to anything or think about anything at the last moment afresh. But imagine these people who go to Kashi only to get moksha. They generally don't have anything else on their mind. The only idea is moksha. Therefore, the Viveka Vairagya is very ripe at that moment. Taking that as a possibility, when Viveka Vairagya is ripe and the mind is completely focused on only on Tattva, Atma Tattva, that time the Upadesha may work. This is the idea. And where is this Kshetra? That is, I've already mentioned. Yatra cha Sarvantaryami Visheshara. This Visheshara, Maheshwara, Vishwasya Ishwara Sarvantaryami, who and who is not really in Kashi alone. He is there everywhere. He is an all-pervading tattva, but since the mahima of Kashi is such that Yatracha Sarvantaryami Vishwasya Sada Sannita, he is always there. Yatracha Ati Gabhira Ganga Uttaravahini Iti Pratita Pravahati. And it is famous that the Ganga there flows upwards उत्तरवाहिनी प्रथिता प्रभवति तत्र काशीनगरे स्थित्वा स्टेइंग देयर इन काशीनगर जस्ट लेट मी फिनिश द फर्स्ट पॉइंट आल्सो स्थित्वा स्टेइंग देयर बट फर्स्ट पॉइंट वाज देयर वाज दिस कथा अबाउट कथा इति सो हियर काचन अपूर्व सो काचन अपूर्व देयर द टिप्पणकार सेज श्रुत्यादिषु उपलभ्यमान जनक याज्ञवल्क्य आदि आख्यायिका आख्यायिका अवदीयम आख्यायिका वत् सो श्रुत्यादिषु उपलभ्यमान इन दि श्रुति एटसेट्रा स्मृति पुराण इतिहास ऑल दोज आर इंक्लूडेड श्रुत्यादिषु उपलभ्यमान जनक जनक कथा इज फेमस याज्ञवल्क्य कथा इज फेमस आदि so many akhyayikas are there there are so many kathas there in the shruti etc and similarly shrutyadishu upalabhyamana janaka yajnavalkya adhyakhyayika vat iyam guru shishya samvadatmika katha this is also in the form of a dialect this katha but why apurva puranadya aprasiddha it is not famous in the puranas etc and even then puranadyapi पुराणाद्य प्रसिद्धा अपि स्वबुद्धि मात्रेण अपूर्वतया कल्प्यते सो द इट इज इमेजिन्ड वे इट वाज नॉट इमेजिन्ड अर्लियर एनीवेयर एल्स दैट्स व्हाई दिस इज अपूर्व दैट काइंड ऑफ अ कथा बैक टू मूल सो तत्र काशीनगरे स्थित्वा राज्यं पालयितुं पुत्रान् आदिदेश स राजा देन दे राजा here he says tatra kashi nagare sthitva staying there he told his children he made an adesha to his children sa raja punarapisa putran avochata what did he say ayam apara samsara dukha rupaha he started by that saying that this samsara is dukha rupa now in his mind he is saying it is dukha rupa for me it may be sukha rupa for you but for me now it has become dukha rupa Become as in I know that it is dukkha rupa. It is swarupena dukkha rupa. Swabhavena. So ayam apara samsaraha dukkha rupa. Staying there, you cannot cross over the samsara. Being in samsara, crossing over samsara is difficult. Impossible. You have to step out. How do you step out? Step out from attachments. So vairagya is needed. Pamarastu tam sukarupam matva. And then he is telling his children, pamaraha. Those who are dullards, who do not think and by saying that he says I myself was a dullard earlier before I got to the conclusion that I am apara samsara dukkha rupah before that I can also be considered as a dullard in that sense otherwise generally who are not who have not studied shastras they are pamaraha pamaraha tu tam sukha rupam matva samsarika bhogaya dhanam eva अत्यादरेण उपार्जयन्ति सो दोज हु कंसीडर द संसार भोग एज सुख रूप दे वॉन्ट टू हैव भोग एंड भोग इज अटेनेबल थ्रू धन देयरफॉर दे गिव प्राइमरी इंपॉर्टेंस टू धन एंड बाय हुक और क्रुक जनरली बाय हुक और क्रुक दे अर्न धन सो दैट दे कैन use it for samsarika bhoga because they think that it is the samsara is sukha rupa thereby samsara bhoga will lead to more and more sukha and for bhoga I need dhana people accumulate dhana natu mukyartham atmavicharam kurvanti they do not do atmavichara which alone will lead to mukti nothing else will lead to mukti atmavichara alone is the way how shravaneena ईदृश पामरजनैः सह वासं विहाय एकान्ते निजसुखलाभाय अहं यतिष्ये इति सो अहं यतिष्ये आई विल टेक एफर्ट्स फॉर व्हाट निजसुखलाभ तदर्थे चतुर्थी निजसुखलाभाय फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ अटेनमेंट ऑफ निज निज मीन्स रियल ऑल्सो इट मीन्स नित्य ऑल्सो आई वॉन्ट नित्य सुख विच इज माई ओन स्वरूप रियली He does not say that here. Atmavichara will lead to sukhalabha. How will Atmavichara lead to sukhalabha? Only if Atma is sukhaswarupa. Otherwise, it is not possible. And these Pamaras are after dhana. You cannot stay along with those Pamaras who are wanting samsarika bhoga and remain an asamsari. It's not easy. This is the reason the Raja is very, you know, is bright. His punya is working so much that earlier he was a yoga brashta. That is why now it is continuing. Nahi kachit durgatin tata gachati. There the Krishna, Gitacharya Krishna says that. One who has taken to this path will never ever durgati, he will never attain durgati. So similarly here, this Raja is continuing his journey, which was blocked due to sukhaboga also. He has earned a lot of punya, and we have seen earlier, for sadhaka, punya also will lead to janma. Earlier, Purva Pakshi was saying that one janma of sukha and then I'll get moksha. But that janma of sukha, if one continues with attachment, it will also lead to further more janmas. But in this case, it is clear that the Raja had some jnana, but he had so much of punya before that jnana became stable, he had to take another janma. And having taken another janma, he had to undergo a lot of punya bhoga, which is in his till his young age, and then there was some punya which worked for his own journey in jnana to continue. So thereby he has taken to vichara, he wants to take to vichara. So he says, natu muktyartham atmavicharam kurvanti idrusha pamarajanehi sahavasam vihaya. I do not want to continue with these kind of people who want to have samsara bhoga, whereas I do not want to have samsara bhoga. So there is a mismatch. If I stay together with these pamarajanas and continue to take care of them or even interact with them, idea is that they will draw me down to their level. Unless nishtha is there, continuing with loka sangraha, you know, welfare of the world, even that, if one does not have jnana and one already has some jnana, has mithyatva nishchaya, that the sukha from the world, samsara, is mithya. Once one gets that idea, then continuing with the samsara has no meaning. Because it will draw the person down, it will bind the person down again. There is a good chance. Thereby, the Raja decided to walk out. And he says, Vihaya, Vasam Vihaya, Ekante Nijasuka Labhaya Aham Yati Sheti. So he said that I will take to the forest. So basically Kashi Nagara there itself, he'll continue his Atma Vicharadu. Putranavi Rajya Jihasa. Now having heard this, like Yajnavalkya told his wives, he had two wives in Upanishad in Brihadaranyaka. We see this some kind of an akhyayika where he says that, Yajnavalkya says that, I have this dhana which I'll divide among you both, and then I would like to take to sannyasa. And when they listen to that, why are you doing that? He says, because I want Nijasukha. He also has the same idea, Nijasukha. He wanted to take Vidvat Sannyasa. He was already a Vidwan. He already had Atma Jnana. But for Nishtha, he wanted to take Sannyasa. Now, what is this Dhana going to get? Wives are interested to know, is the Nitya Sukha that you are pursuing, is it going to be possible through dhana? He says no. So they are also interested in the same path which will lead to nitya sukha and not in dhana. Here what happens is that these putras also, taking cue from that Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, sadhu says that putrana api rajya jihasa. They also want to give up the rajya. Pitruvakyam idam shrutva. They also have enough punya. All three of them have enough punya to get viveka and vairagya. Viveka driven vairagya. So, Pitruvakyam idam shrutva sadyukti buddhi yukti sadyukti buddhi yuktaha trayaha api. So, sadyukti and buddhi yukta trayaha api. All these three children knew, they have studied, because you have seen they have studied shastras. So, they also understood what he is saying at a decently good level. Sadyukti, they use the right logic there, and buddhi yukta, they are buddhi yukta. Sadyukti buddhi yukta trayaha. They had good trained intellect, sharp intellect, sharp enough. Of course, there is gradation in all three, but still they use the right logic. And putraha ekante sambhuya evam samalochayan. So they got together elsewhere. They got together and then sambhuya evam samalochayan. Now they thought away from the father. Pita asman samsara sagare dukkhodarke patayitva swayam brahmanandam pratipatsati. So pita asman samsara sagare asmin, it should be asmin. Pita asmin samsara sagare dukkhodarke. So this samsara sagara, which is Dukkharupa, he himself is saying, this is Dukkharupa samsara, and he is giving this samsara to us, and he is moving out. Patayitva, so he is making us fall into this Dukkharupa, whereas Swayam Brahmanandam pratipitsati. Pratipatum ichchati, he desires to enjoy Brahmananda himself. Whereas he leaves us with this samsara, be it the Trailokya Palana, but still ruling over the three worlds is also going to be Dukkharupa. This samsara sagara is Dukkharupa. I don't want to immerse in this, says one, says the other also, and the third as well. So there were all three understand that since samsara is Dukkha Sagara, Dukkharupa, and the father is going for Brahmananda, then we do not want this either. Yasmad Atma Vicharasaktaha Apara Dukkharupatvad Akhandam Asapatnam Apirajyam Pita Jihasati. They know that the Ohak Tyage Jihasati, he is giving up. He is doing Tyaga. So Tyagam Karoti Pita. Kasya Tyagam Karoti? Rajya Tyagam Karoti. So he gives up the Rajya. What kind of Rajya? Asapatnam Api. Without any enemies, he is ruling over the three worlds without unchallenged emperor. He is an unchallenged emperor, and even then, that kind of an unchallenged kingdom he is ruling, rather. To be accurate, Asapatnam Rajyam. The kingdom which consists of all the three worlds, it is unchallenged, has no enemies. And Yasmad Atma Vichara Asaktaha. He has Asakti to Atma Vichara, because it will lead to Brahmananda, Nijasukha, Apara Dukkha Rupatvad Akhandam Asapatnam. What is Apara Rupa Dukkhatvat Rajyam Jihasati? He gives up the Rajya, although it is unchallenged, it is what? Apara Dukkha Rupa. And therefore, Akhandam Asapatnam Api. It is undivided. This unchallenged and undivided Rajya also is giving up, because why? It is Dukkha Rupa. Apara Dukkha Rupa. He has already said that earlier. The father had told him, the Raja had told him, told the children that it is Apara. I am Apara Samsara Dukkha Rupa. So Apara, they understand this, Apara is Dukkha Rupa. It cannot be crossed over. Dukkha cannot be crossed over Samsara Dukkha while being in Samsara. It is Apara. Thereby, they hold on to that understanding and say, this Apara Dukkha Rupatvad Akhandam Asapatnam Api Rajyam Pita Jihasati Tasmad. And therefore, Vayam Api Idam Rajyam Atyanta Dukkha Rupam Parityajema Iti. We should also give up. We should also give up this Rajya Vayam Api Rajyam Parityajema, completely. Paritaha tyajema. Let us give it up completely. Why? Because there is a hetu garbha visheshana. Atyanta dukkha rupam. It is atyanta dukkha rupam. Apara has been replaced by atyanta. It has to be atyanta if it is apara. Then swagrahat nirgatya trayanam guru pasadanam. Then what should they do? They know the shastra. Thereby, swagrahat, from their own houses, they left. Trayanam guru pasadanam. And they approached a guru. How? That is said further. Evam nirniya te trayopi putraha mumukshavaha shubhasantatir iti pitur naman varthi kuruvantaha sadgurum anveshtum rajagrahat niryayuhu. So they left the Rajagruha, and from Rajagruha they went to find the Guru. Sadgurum anveshtum, to find the Guru, they left their Rajagruha. And they are mumukshus, putra mumuksha, moksha ichu. They are mumuksh, all three having decided. So Niraniya, all three children, mumukshua, they are mumukshu, following pitur nama anvar, pitur nama anvarthi kurvanta shubhasantitihi iti pituhu nama. Their father is called a shubhasantati. He wants shubha. And shubha santati, santati santana, actually it also shows santati is a continuing shubha. Tantu vistare, from that dhatu you get this santana or santatihi. So shubha santati iti pitur nama anvarthi kurvanta. They are making this nama anvarthaka nama. It follows the meaning. Shubha santati, see, generally it is a sanya. Name is just a name. So my parents name me Praveena with some thinking. Does not mean I have Pravinyam. You know, people name their children as Ishwara also. In village side, we have several people who are named as Ishwara. Does not become Ishwara, right? So it's just a name. But here, Shubha Santatir Iti Pitur Naman Varchi Kurvanta. They are making that name meaningful. Because that Shubha is going in the Santati also, Santana also. They are making that name Anvarthaka Nama. It follows the meaning. So parents are blessed, you know, if your children become, they follow the name. In fact, it is said just as a detour. Pooja Swamiji, when he used to initiate people in sannyasa, he used to give names generally looking at them having that the particular characteristic, or he wanted them to become so. This is thinking of every parent also. And Guru being like a parent, he would initiate with a name to this sannyasi also. Sannyasa name would be given to reflect the characteristics of the person. Or he wanted that person to become like that. So with that name also, you follow that name and then become anvarthi kuru. Anvarthi kuruvantaha. These people, sannyasis, become anvarthi kuruvantaha. They follow the name and they fit the name. That is the idea. Sadgurum anveshtum rajagruhat niryayuhu. They left from the rajagruha. Aneka deshan atitva. Having gone to many places, finding the Guru even in that era was not easy. Antataha te Ganga tatam eva prapya. In the end, having gone around to many places, finally came to a Ganga tata, and having come to Ganga tata, tatra vivikte deshe, very solitary place, in a solitary place, atyunnata shakha skanda phalapalasha shalibhihi vrukshaihi nibidite vane kasyachit vatataror mule chinmudraya jiyobrahmaikyam swashishyebhyo nirdushtebhyah upadishantam gunatitam shri sadgurum dadrshuhu. So they saw dadrshu, they saw shri sadguru. Where did they see him? That sadguru in a vivikta desha. So in Gita also, the vivikta desha, you know, that solitary place, which is also forest area, Nibidite, Vane, where, you know, lot of different types of fruit-bearing trees are there. That's how they survive. So, in Vana, Kasyachid Vatataro Mule. So, here Vatataro Mule, you know, imagine Dakshinamurti. who is at the base of the vata. Vata taru. So vatataror mule chinmudraya. Chinmudra also shows the Dakshinamurti. Chinmudra is also representative of Brahma and Jiva Aikya. Thumb represents the Brahma Tattva and the index finger. The Tarjani shows the depicts the Jiva, and Chinmudra is joining them together. When you join them together, it becomes one. Brahma and Jiva is not separable anymore. Nama Rupa Bheda also goes away and it becomes a complete circle. Complete circle is Purna. It is Purna. So Purnatvam is also indicated, Aikya is indicated, and Ananta. What is Purna is Ananta. The circle is complete. If you try to trace the boundary, you will keep on going around the circumference without the end. So it is Purnatvam, which is Ananta. Chinmudraya. Here you see in the Tippana, Angushta Tarjaniya, Angushta and Tarjani, the thumb and the index finger. Angushta Tarjaniya, Tarjani Yoga, Yogaha. So Angushta Tarjani Yogaha Chinmudra iti Kirtyate. That is called as Chinmudra. Iyam Bhadra Mudra, Lopa Mudra, Tarka Mudra, Jnana Mudra iti Kirtyate. And it is called by various names. So he saw, they saw the Guru sitting in, like Dakshinamurti, in Chinmudra. And was he just sitting there doing Jhana? Jiyo Brahma Aikyam Swashishyebhyo Nirdushtebhyo Upadishantam. Kidrashasa Guru, Sri Sadguru, Dadrishu, what kind of Guru did they see? They saw the Guru who is Gunatita, who is beyond Guna. They watched over for a bit and they saw he is Gunatita. He is not giving into his gunas. Upadishantam, and he is a teacher. He is teaching Upadishantam to whom? Swashishyebhya. He is teaching to his Shishyas who themselves are Nirdushta. They could not see any dushta, dosha in the Shishyas also. They were also following the Patha. They may have watched over. So this is an idea which is borrowed from the third chapter and the first two chapters. Shishyas from the first two chapters and a little bit from the third, but the Guru from the third chapter. And what is he teaching? Not Yogasana, not Dhyana, Jiva Brahma Aikyam. He is teaching Aikya of Jiva and Brahma. Here the Tippanakara says, Nirdushtebhya, what are these doshas that shouldn't be there in the Shishya? Steyam, Himsa, Abrahmacharyam, Ityete Trayaha Sharira Dosha. So Sharira Dosha should not be there. What are the Sharira Doshas? Steyam, Himsa, Abrahmacharyam. So we know these meanings, so I'll not go into that. Anrutam, Paraninda, Katubhashanam, Vruthalapaha, Ityete Chatvaro Vagadoshaha, Vagdosha. So Vagdoshas are these four. Anrutam, Anruta Bhashana, Paraninda, Katubhashanam, bitter words. So even if somebody uses Satya, still bitter words. Vruthalapaha, generally wasting away time, blabbering, or Vruthalapaha is, spending time in hearsay, chit-chat, that kind of a thing. Rumors, basically feeding to rumors. Ityete chatvaro vagdosha. Then, Ichha, Chinta, Buddhi, Mandyam, Ityete trayaha, Mano doshaha. The Mana doshas are what? Ichha, Kama basically, Chinta. Worrying about yesterday and tomorrow. Buddhi, Mandyam, slow intellect. All these are manadosha. Manodosha, manas. Manas is sakaranta. Mana is not akaranta. It is manas. Neuter, manodosha. By sandhi, it has become manodosha. Nrusya tapaniya upanishad. Prasiddha ete dashadoshaha. These 10 doshas of the sharira, vak and mana. These are all doshas discussed, 10 doshas in the Nrusya tapaniya upanishad. Then further it is said that so Nirdushtebhya Upadishantam Gunatam Shri Sadgurum Dadrishuhu, they saw Kailase Mahabhandira Vatamule सनकादिभ्य तत्त्वम् उपदिशन्तम् परमशिवम् श्री दक्षिणामूर्तिम् इव ते तम विभाव्य तम गुरुम विभाव्य श्री सद्गुरुम विभाव्य हैविंग सीन दैट गुरु एंड यू नो एक्सेप्टिंग हिम इन विच मैनर एज एज दो ही इज परम शिव श्री दक्षिणामूर्ति हिमसेल्फ हु इज टीचिंग हुम सनकादि मुनीस इन कैलास कैलास से महाभांडीर वटमूले एंड इन 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 कैलास दैट महाभांडी ही Vatamula, which is there, they imagine that kind of a setup here itself and consider themselves as lucky to have found such a guru. Sashtangam pranipatya. And having done Sashtanga, Namaskara, Mokshechaya, Yathavidhi. Yathavidhi. Yathavidhi is Tritiya Tarangokta Vidhanina. As explained in the third chapter, they approach the guru Mokshechaya. यथाविधिं तं शरणं गताः तन्निकटे षण्मासान् ब्रह्मचर्यं ऊषुः सो दे प्रैक्टिस ब्रह्मचर्य दे स्टेड अन्तेवासी दे बिकेम अन्तेवासी एंड देन मोक्षेच्छया दे डिड नॉट टेल देम यू नो टेल द गुरु दैट ओके वी हैव कम हियर स्टार्ट टीचिंग सिक्स मंथ्स दे स्टेड देयर यू नो विद गुरु सेवा इत्यादि दे डिड नॉट इवन एक्सप्रेस देयर विश बिकॉज इट इज सेड दैट ओनली व्हेन द गुरु इज Satisfied, the Ichha should be, Samprashna should be done. Even we see this in the Ashtodhyaya of Chandogya. In the 8th chapter, there Virochana, even Virochana, the king of Rakshasas, and Indra, king of Devata, stayed with Brahma, Chaturmukha Brahma, for 32 years. There 32 years, and 32 years in Brahmaloka, imagine, unimaginable to us. But it is said that there is a Vidhi. Brahmacharya Mushu, so that shows a commitment that my life is dedicated to moksha pursuit. It is not, you know, armchair philosophy. We sit in our cozy homes and then we try to study. It does not bear fruit easily. So here it is said that it is strictly speaking, everything should be given up for moksha. Tataha Shri Sadguru Prasanno Bhutva. He saw them completely committed and after 6 months, Madhuraya Gira Kena Prayojinina Agata Yuyam. KUM Kutovatra Agamanam Iti Tan Papracha. And then Guru himself, being pleased with the Seva, he saw them committed to the ashrama, and then the Guru asked them, Madhuraya Gira, you know, please, and then expressing in sweet words, he asked, why did you come here? With what purpose have you come, all of you? Who are you? And then where have you come from? Iti Tan Papracha. Tada Tattva Drishtihi. भ्रातृरंगी तत्वदृष्टि भ्रात्रोः इंगितज्ञः सांजलिपुटः सविनयं प्रत्यब्रवीत् देन ही आंसर्ड प्रत्यब्रवीत् ही आंसर्ड द गुरु हु तत्वदृष्टि तत्वदृष्टि इज द उत्तम अधिकारी हियर चैप्टर इज कॉल्ड सो तत्वदृष्टि केम टू नो भ्रात्रो इंगितज्ञः सो द यू नो Who is going to answer? So when the guru asked the question, then they started looking at each other, and then he understood the indications given by by his brothers. So bhratroho ingitajna. They must have pantomimed something, and then he got those the indication that why don't you ask? So he sanjali putaha, he with his folded hands, he savinayam. You know, with all humility, he asked. Pratyabravit. What he asked, we'll see further in the next patha. So, Tattva Drishti Gurur Anumatim Prarthayate. He prays for the Anumati of the Guru to ask the question and he expresses the answer as asked. We'll see this in the next patha. This is the background of the story, how they approach the Guru and then now what they ask and how the teaching progresses as a dialectic, we'll see in the next patha. Tomorrow. Sukham Nityam Swaprakasham Vyapakan Nama Rupiho Adhishtanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhya Rukyatu Nirmalam Aparam Sarvedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadeva Tunyat Iti Menishchitamatihi. This story, I hope there are no questions. I'll see you in the next part. Namaste.
Thank you, Hariom.